They trust Donald Trump to do a better job on terrorism than Hillary Clinton by a margin of 52% to 40%. Joining us now, Boris Epstein, a Trump supporter and former communications aide with the McCain campaign, Richard Faller, a nationally syndicated radio host and senior fellow with the New Leaders Council, and Charles Hurt, a political columnist for the Washington Times. Gentlemen, all good to see you. I'll start with Boris here. Donald Trump is a man with no classical training in foreign affairs, a man who's never held office, and yet, Boris, he's resonating with American voters on this very issue of terror. Why?
Because he's able to get to the point. He doesn't parse his words. And he speaks what he believes. He doesn't wait. You look at the clock when Hillary Clinton was making those comments, it was 12:52 Central, about 2 o'clock Eastern. Donald Trump was out 6 hours before then talking about what actually happened. Same thing happened in Brussels. As soon as the Brussels terror attack happened, Donald Trump was on the phone to the radio shows, to the morning shows, giving his views, speaking to the American people. What did Hillary Clinton do? She had a conference call with about 30 of her advisors and then gave a speech at Stanford. That difference is exactly why Donald Trump is leading in the polls as a whole and on terrorism specifically.
You know, Charles, a lot of people say it just feels like he has some common sense. I mean, when people heard about that crash, of course, everyone's mind went straight to where Donald Trump went with the assumption that this very likely could be a terrorism event. Now, we still do not know that for sure, but he came out, as Boris says, hours before anyone else. Is that not a risky thing to do?
Yeah, but he's willing to take risks, and I think that they paid off very well for him. And it may turn out that he is, his declaration that this is terrorism winds up being premature. I think what we're seeing in polling, especially on the issue of terrorism, is that people would far rather have somebody who's a bit premature about something like this than to have someone who for 7.5 years refused to even utter the name of our enemy. And I think that for as long as Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump clash on an issue like this, she can win all the polls she wants to on international handling mm-hmm. international crises. Nobody cares about them. All they care about in terms of this is terrorism.
Richard Faller, does she need to be a little more forthcoming when she's up against the likes of Donald Trump? Does she need to be able to say this is radical Islamic terror? Does she need to at least identify the enemy if she wants to be seen as tough on terror?
Well, Hillary is tough on terror. She's been at the State Department for 4 years. She's led this country's foreign policy and quite effectively at that. Here's the real question we should be asking ourselves, Trish. Do we want somebody like Donald Trump, who's completely unhinged, who has no self-control, running our foreign policy? And the answer to that question is no. You want somebody who's tempered. You want somebody who's strong. You want somebody who's going to hear all the voices and get all the information before they decide to pull the trigger.
I think you bring up an interesting point. No, hang on, Boris. I mean, he's bringing up a very interesting point. Donald Trump is willing to spout off, but let's face it, he's not president yet. Is this part of his political tactic, Boris, because it resonates with voters? They want someone who seems tough. If he were president, would it be different?
It's both a tactic and it is who he really is. This is an authentic candidate, just like Ronald Reagan was an authentic candidate. Now let's talk about what Richard just said. Hillary Clinton was a terrible Secretary of State. Just because she was one doesn't give her any credit whatsoever. Benghazi, China, Libya, Egypt, Russia, all fronts where this country's worse off now after she had been Secretary of State. And our country here, under Obama, Hillary, we had San Bernardino happen here. And who knows mm-hmm. what else could happen.
Yeah, Richard, I mean, they may not have been her policies. They may not have been her policies. However, Richard, she was there. She was Secretary of State. And we have seen an incredible rise in ISIS terrorism in the last 8 years. Will she be tarnished by this?
No, not at all. And here's the thing, where Boris is wrong, right? And
Donald Trump. Back up, Richard. How can she not be tarnished by that? She was part of that administration.
She ran the
right. And here's the thing. What we've seen under President Obama is a rollback on the war in Iraq, rollback on the war in Afghanistan, which are both irresponsible wars taken to task by people who were irresponsible, just like Donald Trump, right? Vietnam, another example of an irresponsible war because we didn't have all the facts. So if we're going to go into war again in a country that is war-weary, we don't want the likes of Donald Trump
being the one with the nuclear code. Charles, she
voted
for the war
decision.
In Iraq.
Both of them were bad decisions.
She voted for the war in Iraq, and she also was part of an administration that got out of there. They hightailed it out as fast as they possibly could, which many believe has led to this rise in ISIS terrorism.
And of course, earlier this week, we just passed Barack Obama broke the record for being at war longer than any president in history, including George W. Bush. But one thing that you can't blame Barack Obama for, you can only accept that he picked Hillary for his Secretary of State, completely in her wheelhouse, is the day after the Benghazi attacks, a coordinated terrorist attack. She had information and knew that. Or should have known that, and instead she lied about it and said that cited some movie, internet movie, mm-hmm. which of course then brought that to the forefront and sparked riots around the world.
So at the end of the day, you're coming back to this poll, as I cited in the beginning of the segment, where Americans see Donald Trump, a man who has no political experience, as the guy who can keep them safe.
He sounds like he knows what he's talking
and
about.
And the reason is, Trish, because
sounding
Hillary Clinton's
and knowing
been
are two
before.
Different things.
Hillary certainly doesn't know.
And she's failed
all right.
at it.
Okay, we're going to have to save this for another day. Gentlemen,
Trish.
Wonderful
different
to
things.
See
and Boris knows
you
that.
All. Richard, we'll talk again soon, I promise. All right, thank you so much. Coming up, everyone, the latest details on the search.